Hello everyone, this is Hoda Genji and this video is created for the George Brown College, the course ARC 3015. So far we just put a point in Dynamo and now we're gonna work on different settings of that point. Okay, so every one of these blocks or items in Dynamo is called a node. And if you right click on it, you see that you have an option to rename the node. Okay, so later when things get complicated, it's a good idea to have your icons named so you can follow the process easier. So when I rename the node, maybe I could name it as the origin point. Maybe I could keep the point.origin. So I know this is a point and this is where I'm going to start my grid. I'm going to accept it. Okay, so you see the name is changed at the top. Another interesting thing is that if you hover your mouse around here, you can pin the information which keeps disappearing. You can pin it here, right? So now it tells me that this point has an x, y, and z of 0, 0, 0. Okay. Now, if I double click here, it brings me a code block. Okay. A code block is the most straightforward way to just put a number or something and then connect it to your parameters here. Right. So let's call each of these items as a parameter. So x, y, and z are my parameters. And if I change them, the design is gonna change and whatever I assign to my X, Y, and Z are gonna be my inputs. For instance, if I put 4, right, so I just clicked here and I just put 4, and if I connect it to my X, what it shows here is that it's a double. By a double, Dynamo means that it's a number, okay? So I can connect it here and as soon as I do that, you see the point is now at 400 rather than 000, right? If I put it and connect it to Y, it's gonna be 040. You get the idea, right? I can also connect it to more than one option. So now it's connected to both X and Y. So now it's 440, okay? If you don't want to see this information, you can hover the mouse around here and check the pin button again. It will go away. I want to have it for now. Okay. If I click on this node, the point gets blue. So whichever node is selected, it's going to show it in blue in Dynamo. Now, if I want to change that number, I can go and change it to something else. You can also go with 5.5 or something. If I go to basics, input, basic, and I bring a number slider, or I can simply type number slider. If you get used to typing the nodes, it's going to be much easier to find them later. Okay, now this is a number slider and you see when I move it to left and right, that number changes there. Okay, so if I delete that code block and use the number slider instead and attach it to like X or something, as soon as I change the number slider here, it's gonna change it over there as well. And maybe I can go with a number between 0 and 10, and I want it to be only like integers. So I'll go with one step each time. So now it's gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, and so on. And then I can click on this point to minimize it. You can also rename this node as well. So I can go to rename node and I want to say this is my point origin x. Okay, so I know this for the x. It's very easy to copy and paste one node. You just need to click on it once so it's selected, and use Ctrl C, Ctrl V. Is gonna copy and paste it here. The second one, I'm gonna rename it as point origin y, and I'm gonna connect it to y. And now let's say if this one is, for instance, 5 and this one is 2, the point is gonna be at 5 to 0. For now, I'm gonna leave z on 0, so it's like in the 0 level here. Okay, and it's on the 0 level on Revit as well. We can change that later. By default, as you see, all three of them are 0, 0, 0. So if you don't assign any number slider or any code number to any of the parameters, that point is always going to be on 0, 0, 0. So we created the point, we created some slider numbers so we can manipulate the location of the point easily later. Now we want to create a set of points or a list of points to have a linear pattern here. So we are on step 2. Let me move that to 0 and 0 for now. You get the idea. If I want to have a set of numbers, I need a list. If you take a look at the items in here, we have a tab only for lists because they're very useful in Dynamo. And if I go to generate, I can go with either a range or a sequence. So if I want to have like 7 points here, I need a list which has 7 elements inside. Now let me move this over here for 1 second, and let me disconnect these two. Okay. If I put this here and also I want to pin the information here. If you compare this item with that item, you see that's a geometry item and that's the point. This is actually a list item and it shows it has 10 items in it. Why do we have 10 items here? Because by default the amount of a sequence is 10. Right, so as soon as I attach this output of this node to the input of this one, I'm gonna have 10 points. Now I have a list of numbers instead. For the sequence, the first parameter is start, the second one is amount, and then there is a step. So by default, the step is on 1. And the start is on 0, it means that it's going to start from 0 and create 10 points, each of which is 1 meter or 1 unit away from the previous one. So let's say if I attach the point origin, the x, to a start, right, and if I change this somewhere, let's say to 2, 3 or something, the points are gonna start from 2, 0, 0. So it's gonna be 2, 0, 0, 3, 0, 0. Okay, now what I can do is that I can define a separate sequence to create my Y options, or I can actually use the same, and I'll show you both ways. So first let me unpin this one for a second so you get the idea. It's only a list of 10 here. Okay, if I click on this item and use Ctrl C, Ctrl V, and this is gonna go to my y parameter here. Okay, so I'm gonna use the point origin y, and I'm gonna use that sequence and attach it to y. Now what happens is that instead of having points which go from 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 2, 0, 0 and so on, we're gonna have points with the same value for x and y. So it's now 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 2, 2, 0 and so on. Okay, so we are getting close. Let me move this a little bit over there. Okay, so we are getting close to have a grid, but we don't have a grid yet, right? In order to have a grid, if I have 10 items here and 10 items here, the grid size should be 10 by 10 or 100. And now, instead of 100 points here, I only have 10. In this case, you need to right-click on this node and go with lacing. Let me move the whole thing a little bit to the left. If you go to lacing and go to cross product, it's going to create the maximum amount of points possible. Okay, so you see I have 10 lists. And each of the lists have 10 items in them. Where does that number 10 come from? It comes from this and this option here, right? So let's say if I copy and paste this number slider here to manipulate the amount of the points, and I'm gonna name this as a point number. So this shows me the number of points on the x direction. Let's say if I put it on 5, you remember by default this is on 10. If I change this to 5, I'm gonna have a set of 5 by 10 points, right? So now I have 5 lists here and I have 10 items in each of them. Where does that 10 come from? It comes from this number here. Right, so let's say if I copy this number slider and rename it as point number, so the number of points in the one in the y direction, and let's say if it's like 7 instead of 10, I should have 35 points rather than 50 when I attach this one to this one. Right, so if I do that, you see I have 35 items. It's a grid by a size of 5 by 7, 5 lists. That 5 comes from here, and there are 7 elements inside each list. That 7 comes from here. And you see, the numbers always start from 0 rather than 1 when we work in Dynamo, right? So you see it's list number 0, list 1. And list 4. Rather than going from 1 to 5, it goes from 0 to 4. That's basically how it works in Dynamo. Okay? Now, I want to rename this node as my grid. So this is the grid. You can see it in Revit as well. And that's gonna be the basis for the center points of the circles. We'll continue the rest in the next video.